This is PetriNet's introduction, part 1. So, in this video, we are going to speak about PetriNet, but we are going to start with a model using GraphSet. This model is available in this link from eGraphSet Plus and corresponds to this example 1, cycle with a single sequence. And in this case, we got a didactic example where we got a car, which is resting in position A. And when a button is pressed, button M, the car is going to position B and then back again to position A. So the model starts with this step where the car is resting. And then when the button is pressed, we pass to this step here where the motor is activated to the right until he reaches the B position and then switches to the left and then back again to A. So the example is here. You can press this and go to eGraphSet Plus. And this is the cycle with a single sequence. And you can activate and see what happens when you press the button. So the car is going to the B, and from B is going to back to the same position A. And you can see the evolution of the GraphSet and also the PLC input and outputs. So we start with this model because there is a great similarity between PetriNet's models and GraphSet. So the basics of PetriNet can be presented with this simple example. We got the places, and then we got the transitions, and finally the arcs that connects the places to transitions. We got also always an alternance between places and transitions. So in this case, the model represents the same problem. The place one, the car is resting, and then the place two activates the motor to the right, place three, the motor to the left, and so on. So the evolution in this case can be presented in this slide. You can see here that the transition one is validated because we have a token in place one. So when the condition associated with the push button M is pressed, then we have transition one fire. We have then the place two activated, and the car is moved to the right until it reaches the B. When it reaches the B, the transition two is fired. And then we got the place 3 activated until the car moves back again to the A position. And when that happens, we return to the place 1, which represents or models the car being parked in the initial position. So now in this example, we are going to consider the famous problem of a chocolate vending machine. In this case, the machine sells only two types of chocolates, A and B. Chocolate A, it costs 15 cents, and chocolate B, it costs 20 cents. The machine is very strange because it only accepts 5 cents coins, which are detected by a sensor, S5, and 10 cents coins, which are detected by a sensor, S10. And also, it does not return changes, so we have to insert the right amount of money for each type of chocolate. When we introduce the right amount, when you press the button A, we obtain the chocolate A. Or button B, then we obtain the machine releases the chocolate B. So the machine does not return any amount of money introduced in excess, okay? So you're going to present now a state diagram, in this case we got five states. The first state represents the initial condition where we don't have any money inserted. It is the state corresponding to 0 cents. And then we got, if you put 5 coin cents, you pass through the 5 cents state. And then we got two possibilities, or either we introduce 5 cents and we go to the 10 cents state, Okay, if you are in initial state and you put 10 cents, you also go to this state and so on. So we can, so if you buy, if you introduce just 5 cents, you begin from 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15. And then, okay, if you want the chocolate A, we press the button. If you want the chocolate B, we have to insert 5 more cents and then push the button B and so on. So there is an equivalence between a state diagram and a Petri-Mat model if the in these conditions where you got the places, in this case place 1 to 5 representing the states. So we got this set of places P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5, and then we got the transition. So in this case, for the equivalence to be true, we can only have one transition, one output transition for each place, and also each transition can only be connected to another place. So each transition has only one place as an input and one place as output. Okay. So we got also the sets of transitions. In this case, we got the set for transition 1. To nine transitions, and the initial state is this one. So it is corresponds to the machine with no money inserted. So also you got here the marking, a set representing the marking of the battery net. In this case, only the position one, place one as a token. So this is the corresponding marking one. 0000, because we don't have any token in this and this and also in place 5. So we are going to present another example here. This is also available in EGRAPHSET Plus, and this is a case of parallelism where you got two cars that are in separate tracks, and when we press a button, in this case it was the button M. The car 1 is going to move between A to B and back again to A, and car C2 is going to move between C to D and back again to C. So they have to start at the same time, C1 from position A and C2 from position C, but then after the starting position they can move in with separate velocities, so they can reach B and D at different times and also return at different times. They can only start again when both cars are in the initial positions. So this is the equivalent model with a Petri-Net, and we can see here that the initial place P1 represents the car 1 and 2 in the initial positions, and then when this transition is true, it means that P is 1, it is fired, so this token then passes to this position and this position. So it means that the car, the motor M2 is going to be activated, so the car C1 is going from to the B position or towers B, and also M4 is going to be activated and C2 is going to position D. Okay, then, for instance, imagine that car 1 is faster. So, when the position B is activated, this is going to be fired. So, this token passes to P3. It means that the car reached this point and now is back again. And then, when it reaches the position A, this token, this transition is fired, and this token passes to place 4. But now, this T6 can be fired. We have to have also the, it is not validated, but because to the transition be validated, both all the input steps have to be true. So you have to wait until the car C2 goes to D, and then back to C again. So the T6 can be fired, and we can be back again to place 1. So this is also available in EGRAPHSET. In example 3, we are going to see it. here. So this is a kind, it's called, in graph set, it's called structural parallelism. And so you can simulate it here. And so if you, in case of the graph set, not in the pedalet, so you can use and see, okay, you can select one car faster than the other and see what happens with the model. But so you can see also here, it's very interesting to see the equivalence between a graph set model and a PetriNet model, okay? And with this example, I finish this presentation, and thank you for your attention.